that yet looks on me or would know me. Ariel. We left here, not one of them that yet looks on me or would know me, Ariel. Fetch me that hat and rapier in myself. So Ariel says, Prospero realizes that none of them means because all of them were distracted, right? Nobody was behaving in a sensible manner, right? They were not in their senses. All of them had gone crazy because of the influence of magic on them, right? So they didn't recognize Prospero. And again, it was not easy for them to recognize Prospero because Prospero was dressed as a magician. He was not able to, so he was not looking like a king, right? Not looking like a Duke of Milan. And so they didn't recognize. Perhaps this might be the other reason why they didn't recognize Prospero. Fetch me the hat and the rapier in myself. Fetch me the hat and the rapier in myself. So he says that bring me my hat and rapier. Rapier means bring my hat and sword from my cell, from the cave. Exit Ariel and returns immediately. So exit leaves the place and then he comes back immediately. I will decase me. I'll decase me means I will disrobe me. I will just go and change this garb of a magician. I will go and take off these garments of a magician and I will dress myself as the Duke of Milan. Means the way he used to dress himself when he was in Milan. So I will disrobe myself and myself present as I was sometime Milan. So now I am going to present myself in the manner I used to dress when I lived in Milan. Quickly, spirit, thou shalt ere long be free. So Prospero instructs Ariel that you should be very quick. You should move very fast, right? Be very active. Why? Because the time when you will gain your freedom, the time when you will be free, right? The time when you will be liberated, right? That is approaching, right? So the faster you work, the earlier you will be free. Re-enter Ariel, who sings while helping to attire Prospero. So now Ariel re-enters and with Prospero's dress, and so he helps to dress up Prospero. And he says, where the bee sucks, there suck I. And then he starts singing. Ariel starts singing also. Where the bee sucks, there suck I. So I suck from the place where the bee sucks. Means where the bees, they suck nectar from the bees suck nectar from the flowers. I also suck nectar like the bees from the flowers. In cowslip's bell I lie. Cowslip is a type of a flower. So I lie, I rest myself in the petals of the bell-shaped petal. Cowslip is a type of a flower whose petals are bell-shaped, right? So I lie, I relax myself, I take rest in the bell-shaped petals of this particular flower. There I couch when owls do cry. So I go and I hide myself in the couch, means there I go and I hide myself in those petals when the owls, they start shrieking, when the owls, they start crying. On the bat's back, I do fly after summer met me. And what else I do? I'll just go and I'll fly on the bat's back. Means I'll go and I'll sit on the back of a bat and I will fly after summer merrily. And I will go in chase of summer. Means I'll go in search of summer. Merrily, merrily shall I live now. So now, see, this song is sung by Ariel to express his happiness. And why is Ariel happy? Because he knows that he'll be a free spirit, right? After some time, he'll be liberated. He will gain his freedom. And everyone likes to be free. So this is, through this song, Ariel is expressing its happiness. So he says that I shall now live happily. And merrily, merrily shall I live under the blossom that hangs on the bough. So I shall live happily beneath the shade of the flowers, under the shade of the flowers that hang from the branches of the trees. So this is the meaning of the song, which was sung by Viral. Means I will relax myself by sitting on under the shade of the flowers which are hanging from the branches of the tree. So Prospero says, why, that's my dainty. Ariel, so this is, yes, indeed, really, you are my delicate Ariel. Dainty means you are my delicate Ariel. I shall miss thee. I'll miss you, right? Because he expresses his sadness, his sorrow over the loss of Ariel, right? Because he'll leave the island and then he'll never be able to meet Ariel. And so he says that I will definitely miss you. I'll definitely feel your loss in my life, but yet thou shalt have freedom. But still, I promised you that you will get your freedom, and so you will be free. You need not worry about it. So, thank you. Then he says, thank you. He expresses his gratefulness to, so is a reference, so means he is expressing his gratitude towards Ariel, that you have done a worthy service to me. You have always been a very obedient servant to me, and so I will miss you, and I am very grateful for your service. Then he gives instructions. What is Ariel supposed to do next? What is he supposed to do next? To the kingship, invisible as thou art, there shalt thou find the mariners asleep under the hatches. So he says that Ariel, though invisible you are, in this particular form only, in this invisible way only, you are supposed to go where? Go to the place near the sea, where they have, where the ship is kept, where the ship is there. The ship, you know that there was no real shipwreck in the beginning. It was just an illusion, right? The ship didn't wreck. It reached the harbor safely. It reached the shore. It reached the island very safely. And so, now Prospero instructs Ariel that now you are supposed to go to that ship, right, which is the king's ship. Go to that king's ship, and what are you supposed to do there? There shall thou find the mariners asleep. And what will you find there? Once you will go to that ship, you will find the sailors and other people. You remember the boatswain, the captain and all these people? Where are they? They are still inside that ship. So there you will find these mariners and the other people who are on board the ship. They are asleep. They are sleeping under the hatches. Under the hatches mean under the deck. They are sleeping. The master and the boatswain being awake enforce them to this way. So now I instruct you that once you will go there, you will find that the master and the boatswain, these two people, they must be awake. Right? By the time you will reach there, they'll be awake. And what are you supposed to do? You have to force them. Enforce them means you have to force them to come to this place. You are supposed to go there, go to the ship, and bring the master of the ship and the boatswain to this particular place, to the place where I am present. And presently I pray thee. And then he says, and you are supposed to do this immediately without any further delay. I pray thee. I pray thee means I request you to do this immediately. Ariel, I drink the air before me and return, or air your pulse twice beat. So he says, I will fly as quickly as the wind moves. I will fly with the speed of the wind, with the speed of the air, and I will come back before your pulse beats twice. Before you, the pulse beats very quickly, right? You know what is a pulse? You check your pulse from here, right? From the place near your wrist, right? So he says that I will go there with the speed of the air, with the speed of the wind, and I will come back before your pulse beats twice, right? So I'll be very quick. This is what Ariel means to say. All torment, trouble, wonder and amazement inhibits here. So Gonzalo says that, now Gonzalo realizes, he is like on seeing the condition of all these people, he says, all torment. So this is the place where there is torment, where there is trouble, where there is a lot of wonder, where there is a lot of amazement, where there are a lot of surprises, where there is a lot of torture, inhibits here. Inhibits here means all these things exist here in this particular island. So the crux of the thing is that he wants to say that this is an enchanted island. You don't know what will happen to you in this island, with a lot of unnatural things taking place in this island. Some heavenly power guide us out of this fearful country. So now Gonzalo is praying, and Gonzalo says that I request some heavenly power, some godly power to come here and to save us, some divine power to interfere and save us from this fearful place. Right? This island is not worth living because there are some unnatural incidents happening on this island, and so I pray to God that please some divine interference, and we should anyhow be saved from this island, from this country. Prospero, behold, sir king, the wronged Duke of Milan. Behold means look. So now Prospero has dressed himself like the Duke of Milan, and so he says, look at me, sir king, the wronged Duke, and he is talking to Alonso, right? So after changing his dress, after changing his robe, he talks to King Alonso, and he says, look at me, sir, I am the wronged Duke of Milan. Means I am the Duke of Milan who was not treated properly, right? To whom injustice was done. Prospero, for more assurance that a living prince does not speak to thee. So he says that for more assurance, I want to tell you that I am a living person and speaking to you. So he tells his name also, that I am Prospero, I am the Duke of Milan to whom injustice was done, and to assure you, I want to tell you that I am a living human being, I am a living person, and I am talking to you at this present moment. I embrace thy body, and to thee and thy company I bid a hearty welcome. And then he says that to make you believe that I am a real living person, I am alive, right? I am not some spirit, I am not some unnatural thing. So that is why I hug you, I am ready to embrace you, I am ready to give you a hug, and I welcome you and your companions, I welcome you and your followers on this particular place, on this island. See, now after entering that circle, all of them have regained their senses. Now they have started behaving like normal human being, right? Till this particular time, because they were under the influence of Prospero's magic, so they were behaving like crazy people. So now after that circle, the influence of Prospero's magic was removed from them, and they started behaving like normal. They regained their sensibility. Alonso, whether thou beest he or no, or some enchanted triple. See, but now King Alonso and his companions have seen so much, have faced so much on this island, that they are skeptical about anything, about everything. And so Alonso says, whether thou beest he or not. So whether you be Prospero or not, I cannot be very sure, or some enchanted triple, or you might be some unreal appearance also. I cannot say for sure, because we have seen, we have faced, we have been tortured to a great extent on this island, and so I cannot really be very sure about you, whether you are really Prospero or you are some illusion, some unreal appearance standing in front of me to abuse me as late I have been. I not know. So he says that abuse me here means to deceive me. I really cannot be very sure whether you are real Prospero or you are just some unreal appearance, some illusion who have come here to deceive me, to cheat me. I cannot say, because I have been recently, in the very recent past, I have been deceived by these illusions. Thy pulse beats as of flesh and blood. So then he hugs Prospero, he embraces Prospero, and then he realizes, King Alonso realizes, that he feels like human, his pulse is beating. So that is what he says. But you don't seem to be unreal. Why? Because your pulse beats like human being, right? Like flesh and blood means like humans, right? Your flesh, your pulse is beating like the pulse of human being. So I really doubt whether you are a spirit. It seems that you are a real human being. And since I saw thee, the affliction of my mind amends with which I fear a madness. So, and since I saw thee, and after seeing you, as a living human being and not an illusion, the affliction of my mind amends. I am feeling that my brain is regaining its senses. My brain has started functioning properly. My brain has started functioning normally, with which I fear a madness healthy, which I am very sad to say, which I really fear, which I really doubt that some kind of madness, some kind of craziness afflicted my brain a short while ago, and now I have regained my senses. Right now I have come back to my senses after meeting you, after seeing you, after embracing you, I have again regained my sensibilities. This must crave as if this be at all a most strange story. So he says that this must crave, this must be if this is true, right? If whatever I am saying and if whatever I am feeling at the right moment, if this is really true, then it is definitely going to make a very wonderful and a very strange, very unbelievable kind of a story, right? See, it's not believable. All these things which are happening to him, they are full of a lot of amazement, wonder and surprise. So that is why he says that if everything is exactly the way I am understanding, right, if everything happening to me is the way which I am able to make out, then definitely this is going to make a wonderful story, wonderful and a strange story. The dukedom I resign and do entreat thou pardon me my wrong. So Alonso says that now Alonso has finally realized that Prospero is alive. Prospero was not dead, right? And the person who is standing in front of him is not an illusion. He is a real human being and he is real Prospero. Alonso has finally realized this particular thing. And so he says that thy dukedom I resign. And I have something more to tell you, that I have decided to resign your dukedom, means I am ready to give away that dukedom, the dukedom of Milan to you. That you remember that annual tribute which Antonio was supposed to pay. So I am ready to give up my claim of that annual tribute. Right? So, and do entreat thou pardon me my wrong. And I request you, I entreat you, it is my humble request that please forgive me for my wrongs, for my evil deeds which I committed in the past. That is my request to you. I request you to please forgive and forget all the atrocities which have been inflicted upon you by me. But how should Prospero be living and be here? So then he realizes and then he is not able to understand and say that but how is it possible that Prospero is alive and Prospero is on this island, right? The island where nobody lives, right? So he is not able to connect all the facts together. And so he says, fine, I'm ready to give away your kingdom, I'm ready to resign from my dukedom, but I still want to know that how is it that our ship wrecked on this island. See, Alonso is not aware of the fact that all these things have actually been done by Prospero, right? Till now he considers it to be some natural calamity, the shipwreck as being some natural calamity, right? He is not aware of the fact that there was Prospero's hand in all these things. So that is why he asks, but how is it possible that Prospero is alive and I am meeting you on this island, this strange island? Prospero to Gonzalo, first noble friend. So Prospero ignores his question and he moves to Gonzalo, and to Gonzalo he says, first noble friend, let me embrace thy knee. So he says, he moves to Gonzalo and he says, now Gonzalo, I would like to embrace you. First of all, I would like to hug you. I would like to embrace you. Thine age means you old man, you aged man. I would like to embrace you, whose honor cannot be measured or confined. You who are so great, your greatness is immeasurable and it cannot be limited, it cannot be restricted. Your greatness is beyond measurement and your greatness is beyond limits. Right. Gonzalo, whether this be or be not, I'll not say. So now Gonzalo is also very confused. He says, I really am not going to take an oath. I am not going to swear whether all these things which are happening to me are real or unreal. Who? Arunima? The rest of you? Am I audible? Arunima, there must be some problem at your end then. If only you are not able to hear, then there must be some problem at your end. Just check. Now am I audible? Your connection must not be stable. Now am I audible? No. Try to reconnect. So Gonzalo says, whether this be or be not, I'll not say. So Gonzalo says, I really am not sure whether you are a real human being or you are an illusion, but I'm not going to take an oath. I'm not going to swear about this particular fact. Prospero, you do yet taste some subtleties. So he says that you do yet taste. So Prospero says that you seem to be still under the influence of some illusion, because you people have gone through so much, so you still are not completely out of it. You still seem to be under the influence of some enchantment, some illusion of the isle, which is something which is very common on this island. Some enchantment of the island, some illusion of the island that will not let you believe things certain, which is restricting you from believing something which is certain, right? So I am standing in front of you as something real, as a real human being, right? So I am a reality standing in front of you and you are skeptical about it. So it must be because of the influence of this island. Now Arunima, can you hear me? So that will not let you believe things certain. So which is restricting you from believing things which are certain, which are real. Welcome my friends all. So Prospero welcomes all of them, all the courtiers and all the lords which were with Alonso. A side to Sebastian and Antonio. And then he takes Sebastian and Antonio to one side. He welcomes all of them and then he takes Sebastian and Antonio to one corner. And what does he say to them? But you, my brace of lords, were I so minded. So he says, and you too. Brace means two, right? Couple. So, and you too, lords, were I so minded, I here could pluck his highness frown upon you and justify you traitors. So he says, you, my dear people, you two of them, if I desire, what I can do, if I am inclined, if I have any intention, what I can do, I can make the king angry. His highness is a reference to King Alonso. I can make the king angry. I can make the king go against you people for the deeds which you did. What deed did they commit? They conspired to kill Alonso. So that is what Prospero is telling them, that if I want, I can just go to King Alonso and I will tell him that you people made plans to kill him, right? You people attempted to kill him, then he will definitely be annoyed with you, right? So I know your reality, I know what was going in your head, and I can expose both of you very easily if I am inclined to do so. So minded means if I am inclined to do so, if I have any intention to do so, I can do all this to you. And then what will happen? His Highness, that is King, will be very annoyed and angry with you and justify you traitor. I can make him believe, justify you traitor means I can make the king believe that both of you are traitors, both of you are not loyal people. At this time, I'll tell no tale. But I forgive both of you, right? I am ready to forgive you people also. Why? Because I am not in a mood. I don't want to do all these things. I don't want to go and tell the truth about you people to the king. So I'm not going to tell your story. I'm not going to tell your tale to the king. Sebastian aside, the devil speaks in him. So Sebastian moves to one side and he says he is a devil. There is some devil inside him which is talking, right? Because this was kind of blackmailing, right? Which Prospero was doing. Right? If I want, I can do this, but still I don't have any plans to do it. So Sebastian moves to one side and he says that he is not Prospero. Some devil has entered him and he is talking like this. Prospero. Then Prospero talks to Antonio. This the next speech is spoken by Prospero to Antonio. Prospero is speaking to Antonio. Prospero to Antonio, no, for you, most wicked sir, whom to call brother would even infect my mouth. And you, sir, who is the most wicked person I have ever seen on this earth. And it is even polluting my mouth to call you a brother. I will, like, if I call you a brother, who was Prospero's brother? Antonio. So that is why he is addressing this speech to Antonio. He says that to call you my brother is like infecting my mouth. Right? It's like polluting my mouth. I'm soiling my mouth if I call you my brother because of the deeds which you have done, because of the way you have behaved with me in the past. I do forgive the rankest fault. But still I am forgiving you. The most rankest means the most hateful, right? The worst deed which you have committed, I am ready to forgive that also. All of them. It's not only one deed which you did. You did several such evil deeds in the past, and all of them I am ready to forgive. I am ready to forgive all the pain and all the misdeeds which you have committed against me. My dukedom of thee, which perforce I know, thou must restore. So he says, I am ready to forgive everything, and what I want my dukedom back now. Right? Now you are not going to be the Duke of Milan, I'll be the Duke of Milan. Which perforce means which, whether you want or whether you don't like, right? Whether you like or whether you don't like, whether you want or whether you don't want, anyhow, willy-nilly, you will have to give back my dukedom to me. I will have it now, right? I know thou must restore. You will have to restore my dukedom to me anyhow, whether it's your wish or not. You will be forced to do it now. Alonso, if thou beest Prospero, give us details. So now Alonso says that if you are really Prospero, I want to know the details of thy preservation. Of thy preservation means how you were saved, because you were sent out in the sea on a stormy night, right, to die. But how did you manage to be alive all these years, right? So I want to know the details. I want to know the details of your story. How thou hast met us here, who 3 hours since were wrecked upon this shore, where I have lost. How sharp the point of this remembrance is, my dear son. So he says, and how did you manage to be alive? And how is it possible that I met you on this island, on this enchanted island, who 3 hours since? So it has just been 3 hours that we landed on this island, and from where did you come on this island? He is not aware of the fact that this island belongs to Prospero now. Prospero has been living on this island all these years. From the past 12 years, he has been living on this island. Alonso is not aware of this fact. So that is why he asks that we have just landed on this island 3 hours ago when our ship was wrecked, were wrecked upon the shore. When our ship was wrecked and we landed on the shore. And how did we meet you here? Where I have lost. And it is because of this shipwreck that I lost my son Ferdinand. How sharp the point of this remembrance is. And then he again goes back into his sorrow, into his pain, and he says, it is such an acute pain, it is such a terrible pain, the memory of my son, right? The memory of my losing my son, it gives me such terrible pain. It gives me such acute pain, my dear son, my Ferdinand. And then he starts feeling sad about the death of his son. He says, my dear son Ferdinand, it's really very painful to remember him. I think we should end here now. Okay. We'll start from this point tomorrow. I'll complete this act by 20th. Right. Then I'll be uploading the assignment in July. So that's all. Any questions? Anything you want to ask? No. Fine. Thank you.